thought this concept was a good idea. If you remember Castaways or Deep Sea Divers, you'll remember that an element of those minigames was rotating the control stick as quick as possible. This game takes that concept and makes it worse, so much worse. In those ones, rotating the control stick was just an element of the game that you didn't have to do from start to finish. This amps it up a notch by making it the only thing you have to do. There's no strategy, there's no resting, only spinning. Like being a hamster on the wheel of society. This minigame and the others like it actually led to a lawsuit against Nintendo after Mario Party came out. They were ordered to send out gloves to anyone with the game who requested it. The gloves had no Nintendo branding of any sort on them, probably to prevent people from feeling like they had to get them. And as far as I could see online, they were just regular fingerless gloves. Apparently to get them, you had to send proof of purchase as well as an outline of your hand, which I think is hilarious. I'm not sure if they wanted the outlines to know which size to send or what, but I feel like giving the option of sizes would have done the job just as well. Seriously though, I hate this game. You're pretty much forced to use the palm of your hand to rotate the control stick if you want to do well, and that means getting second-degree burns. Do you want to win? Is it worth physical pain? Well, buck up, kiddo, because this is Mario Party. It's not just your character dying in the minigames, it's you. Like I said, there's no strategy to it at all. It's a 1v3 minigame, so there's one person on one side of the raft and three on the other. The harder your side paddles, the more the boat goes to the other side of the river where shy guys on the shore await to stab your money out of you. You're playing for the coins you already have, so if the single player gets poked, the three other characters each get a coin from them, and if the three characters get poked, the single player gets a coin from each of them. So there's good money to be made here. The more you hurt yourself, the richer you can get. The only question becomes how sadistic you are and how much you love money. It forces everyone to try and spin the control stick maniacally out of fear of losing their money. You start rotating the control stick faster and faster with your palm, trying to stay away from the edge, which makes the other side rotate faster as well, which in turn causes your side to compensate by rotating even faster. It's a never-ending cycle of torture and defeat. I mean, it does eventually end, but it never ends well. Well, it can end well if you came out with more coins, but still, your palm hurts, so... Again, I hate this game. It's not a fun concept, and it literally hurts to play. I wish it was never included in Mario Party, and whoever decided it was a fun minigame to throw in is sadistic and twisted. This one is getting my very first ever 1 star out of 5. Don't play this one. If it ever comes up in a Mario Party game, make a pact as a group to put your controllers down, have a snack, and leave the minigame as equal as you went in. It's the only way to beat it. You can't let it win. Okay, come back tomorrow for another awesome Mario Party minigame. We're done with Paddle Battle, and as much as it sucked playing this game for review, it's over now. I may have disliked some of the minigames I've played before, but even a bad game like Buried Treasure is preferable to this. At least I know that whatever I play tomorrow won't be as bad as Paddle Battle. If you need a taste of what a better minigame is, subscribe, hit the bell, and join me tomorrow when we'll surely find out with Pedal Power. Hope to see you then! Finish.